Okay, let's recap where we are. So we're talking about strategies to do efficient CUDA programming, and the first thing we've talked about is using high arithmetic intensity, trying to get your ratio of math operations to memory, time spent accessing memory, as high as possible. And so far we've been talking about the denominator. The goal has been to minimize the time spent on memory. Part of that is simply moving data to faster memory if you're going to access it a lot, keeping in mind that, you know, the fastest memory of all is local variables, followed by shared memory, followed by global memory. Another thing you can do is use coalesced global memory accesses. So when you are accessing global memory, try to do it quickly. And the trick there is adjacent threads are accessing a contiguous chunk of memory. Usually they're accessing adjacent memory locations. Well, what else do we need to think about when we're writing efficient CUDA programs? In addition to striving for high arithmetic intensity, we also want to avoid thread divergence. Let me explain what that means. So in parallel threads, like the threads in our trusty thread block, do something different, we say they diverge. So we had some code that looked like this in a kernel. You're doing some stuff, and you reach an if statement, and you say, if condition is true, then execute some code, else execute some other code, and you proceed. So if you think about a whole bunch of threads in a kernel executing this code, all these threads are going to get down here. So these threads are going, they're going to hit this condition, they're all going to execute this condition, and then some of those threads are going to take the if branch, some of them are going to take the else branch. So this thread proceeds, hits the condition, and then let's say it takes the if branch. Maybe this thread proceeds when it hits the condition, maybe it takes the else branch. Perhaps this thread takes the else branch as well, and maybe this thread takes the if branch. Okay, so these threads have diverged. Of course, in this particular case, afterwards, they're going to all proceed together again. So this thread's going to keep on going, finish the if code. This thread will keep on going, finish the if code. These two threads will each keep proceeding and do the else code. And then they'll all converge again. And you might notice that I tried to draw them so that they kind of reassemble into the same order they were. In fact, their thread IDs have never changed. Okay, this is still thread 0, this is still thread 3, this is still thread 1 and thread 2. So their thread indexes don't change. It's just the path that they're executing through the program is different. So that's what divergence means. This is thread divergence, threads that do different things.